Welcome to the viewers to our channel program today. Today we are going to be looking at how we can install our program, which is Flutter, on our machines and see how we can start using it to develop applications. Remember, in our previous videos we looked at different frameworks and cross-platform being the major platform in developing applications in mobile development. So today we are going to be looking at how we can install Flutter and start using it to develop applications. Right about now, let's dive into the practical part of it and see how we can install this program on our computers and develop our first application. Welcome once again to our next part of this video. We are going to be seeing how we can install this software on our computers. And I've put aside some steps that we need to follow to install this SDK on our computers. Number one will be downloading this a bundle or SDK from the different from this URL, which is flutter.io. Number two will be setting a temporary path on our computers. Number three will be running Flutter Doctor to check, in other words, we'll be checking whether there are other dependencies that we need to install on our computer. Number four will be installing Visual Studio Code. Visual Studio Code is the easiest and the best editor that I've chosen for this tutorial for us to learn, and the flexible that we can use than other editors, but there are multiple editors out there. So number five will be installing a .dot code extension on our computer. So in our Visual Studio Code, so this is what we're going to use to install. Number six is setting Flutter SDK path, which is a folder. You can call it a folder or a specific location where you're going to install the SDK on the computer.
Today we are going to see how we can install this on macOS. So we go to flutter.io and opens, we go to get started. We have different platforms where we can install Flutter that will use macOS, and these are the system requirements for macOS. We have 64-bit OS, and we have this space of 700 required in Mac. And tools, these are the different tools that need to be installed for Flutter to work function properly, and you can find them on the latest OS that is available there. So we go to where I say download, click on download, and it will pop up the download. The download is 400 MB, and we click OK to install. Then it will wait for it to download, but I'm not going to download because I already have it installed on my Mac. So when you find that you go to my download folder, you see I already have it here. So the next thing we do that we go to where we save the folder, the extract the package. So my folder is in download. I'll just paste this link here, and then just unzip it from there. Since I already have it, this one will ask me to overwrite, but I will not, since I already have it. And you go and copy this command and you paste it. You find it in the link below in the description. You go and just paste this one. It will add the Flutter tools to your path, so you have it set here. And then after that, we run the Flutter Doctor to check and see whether there are other dependencies that we need to install. After that, we run Flutter Doctor to check for the other dependencies, and we wait for it to check for you. So let's wait. filter has finished checking and we see that we have Flutter installed. It is 0.io installed on my machine. And we have Android Studio installed, we have Visual Studio installed, and we have an device connected. I have an emulator which is open. So this one is also seen as a device, and we have toolchain also installed iOS. So far I'm ready to go. But for some of you over there, we saw that in our list of things we need to do, we have to install the Visual Studio Code, and that one we can simply go to code dot visualstudio.com. Studio code. I'll just copy this area and paste it here. So when it opens, you see we have whereby to, if or depending on which operating system you are on, it will just pop up the specific download that you need for your machine. Now since I'm on Mac, it is asking me to download for Mac. So I will go ahead and show me to bring me to this page. Thank you for downloading the map, and the download link will pop up immediately. So if the download doesn't start, you can click on this directly and the download will pop up. So it has popped up, and then you click download. So since I already have it installed, I want to go ahead and download this. I have it, so I'll go ahead and go to my download folder, and you see I have Visual Studio Code here. Already unzip that one and then install. And after install, if you're on Mac, just copy the installation and send it to the application folder. After that, you launch the Visual Studio Code. So after launching the Visual Studio Code, you have something like this. You have something like this to be new without anything. So what you do, you have to go to extensions, where there is extensions here, and then search for that code that you needed to install on our machine. So I have that code there. So I already have it installed on my machine, so I want to go ahead and install that. So after installing that, we are ready to go. What do we need to do? We just now need to go to view, to command palettes, and then say add new Flutter. And then we name our Flutter like hello world. Hello, but it has required naming the project hello world 1. So I just click enter, and then it will ask me for a specific directory or folder that the projects will be in. So I'll select that one, and then it will start to create the project for me. My hello world is under creation now. So we wait. So it's running Flutter Create Hello World project, so we wait for that. It's finished running the project, so after running that, and this is the file that we'll be using to write our code from. So it will have the main.dot file, and which we will be using to install, to run, to do the programming, writing our applications from. So let's run our Hello World application and launch it on the device. See, we'll go on debug and run debug. Yes. Run, and then run your device into mainnet. So now after launching this program and running Flutter, so we're going to run our first program. So we click the play button to run our program on the emulator. If you see, I already have an emulator which is launched, and it's an iPhone emulator, iOS emulator, that you can use that on Android. So I'm using iOS for this demonstration, and you see it's launching. So after that, it launches and we wait. So wow, this is our first application in Flutter. We are so excited to see that we have made our first progress by running our first application using Flutter. So this is just a simple on click event button application, which is just when you click here, it shows you the number of times, it counts the number of times that you have clicked the button. But it's very simple, but it's all the it's all that we need to start for start developing any application out there. Thank you for watching. See you next time as we develop complex UIs and applications in Flutter.
Please remember to subscribe on our channel for more videos. Thank you for watching. See you in our next video, which is coming next week.